Okay, so now that we know general things about the simple interest and the compound interest, we'll be looking at the different types of interest rates which could be given to us and how to compute one interest rate from the other. So now till now we have been doing that the compound interest rate which was given to us was actually compounded annually, but the compounding can also be done for other small time periods like semi-annually or quarterly or monthly, or for that sake any time period, it could even be done daily. So the compound interest rate that is given to us in the problem normally is the nominal rate of interest. So if we are given that the compound rate of interest, so if we are given that the compound rate of interest is 10%, but compounded, so this is 10% per annum, compounded suppose quarterly. So what does this exactly mean? So till now what we were doing is, if this is the time period, if this is the timeline, and suppose this is 3 month period, this is 6 month, this is 9 month, and this is 12 month. This is the time point zero at which we borrow a principal amount of P. So now we are given that 10% compounded quarterly. So when we go from 0 to 3 months, we cover 1 quarter. So there must be some compound interest which is done from 0 to 3 months, because compounding is being done quarterly here. What will it be? So the total amount of the new principal which will be obtained at 3 months would be nothing but P into 1 plus R upon 4 and into 100, because it's percentage. So this will be the new principal at the end of 3 months. So why we divided R by 4 is, the 10% interest rate is for 1 year, but we have to calculate the interest rate for 3 month period. So it will be R upon 4, because there are 4 quarters in 1 year. So R upon 4. So basically from 0 to 3 months, we'll pay 2.5% compound rate of interest. Now this becomes a new principal at the end of 3 months. So now from going from 3 to 6 months, we will again have to pay 2.5% but on the new principal. So we will again multiply it by 1 plus R upon 4 into 100 and so on till 4 quarters. So what will this be? The general formula for this will become P into 1 plus R upon 400 raised to power 4. So this is the general way how we compute the amount if the compounding is done for a smaller time period. Now we'll look at another question to discuss the difference between the nominal rate of interest and the effective rate of interest. So here we have been given, if the rate of interest is 10% per annum and rate of interest is compounded every 4 months. So here every 4 months we are compounding it. What is the effective rate of interest? Okay, so we'll again draw a number line because that gives us a good visualization. So we have a time period of 0, then first compounding is done till 4 months, then it is done till 8 months, and then at the end of the year, which is 12 months. So we are having 3 times compounding here. So we have been given the rate of interest is 10% per annum. That is the nominal rate of interest, because as we saw before, the rate of interest generally given in the problem is the nominal rate of interest. This is 10% per annum. Okay. Now what will be the, if we are taking one suppose principal at time zero, then what will be the final amount at the time period of 12 months? It will be nothing but 1 into 1 plus R upon, so this is R upon 3, because we are compounding it thrice in 1 year, into 100, because R is a percentage, raised to power 3, because we are compounding it thrice. So this becomes the final principal amount, which is, so this is the final amount at the end of 12 months. And if the effective rate of interest, let R, capital R, be the effective rate of interest. So effective rate of interest is treated as if we are compounding it annually. So what will it be? 1 plus R. Because we are doing a, we are compounding it annually. So it will come only once because we are doing it for 1 year. Okay. So now we simply have to plug in the values. R is given to be 10. So, and this becomes 1 plus 10 upon 100 is 0.1. So this becomes 0.1 upon 3, which is 0.033 raised to power 3 equal to 1 plus capital. So now if we cube this particular term, we'll get a value of 1.1034. This is equal to 1 plus R. So R comes out to be 0.1034, which is 10.34%. Therefore, the effective rate of interest is 10.34%, which is greater than the nominal rate of interest of 10%, which is also intuitive by the fact that we are compounding it thrice in 1 year. So more compounding effect will be seen, and therefore the effective rate of interest is greater than 10%, which is the given nominal rate of interest. This is how we compute the effective rate of interest from the given nominal rate of interest.